This is a precipitation. Precipitation means the water which comes back to the earth surface in the various forms like rainfall, snowfall, hail, sleet. That is known as precipitation. So it is, the precipitation is in various forms. The precipitation may be in the form of snow, rain, hail, sleet, etc. So what are the types of this precipitation? So there is a, although there is a moisture present in the atmospheric air, but it is condensed only when the air is cooled. When the moisture which is always present in the atmosphere, but it is condensed only when the air is cooled. So that it becomes saturated with the same amount of water vapor. So condensation process that will start when the air is cooled, when the water pressure, when the water vapor that is get accumulated in the atmospheric air. So after accumulation, the pressure will go increase and the condensation process will start. And that atmospheric air, when it gets cooled, the condensation process will start. And the air is completely saturated with that same amount of water vapor. So by this process, due to this mechanism by which the air is cooled to cause precipitation. Due to cooling of the air in the atmosphere, that may causes precipitation. So that may lift the air mass. So during this process, the air mass is lifted up. Lifting of air mass during the process of this condensation. The mechanism by which the air is cooled to cause precipitation is lifting of the air mass. There are three different methods by which the air mass gets lifted to cause cooling and condensation of the atmospheric water vapor. So there are three different methods are there by which the air mass gets lifted. Due to which what happens that may cause cooling and condensation of the atmospheric water vapor. Due to which what happens, the precipitation that may occur, precipitation in the form of rainwater, snowfall, or hail, sleet, that may come on the earth surface in various forms, depending upon the way in which the air is cooled. So the precipitation that may occur according to that, depending upon the way in which the air is cooled, the precipitation that may occur. There are three kinds of precipitation are there. One is cyclonic precipitation. Second one, convective precipitation. Third one is orographic precipitation. A precipitation che three types hai. Cyclonic precipitation, convective precipitation and orographic precipitation. A precipitation che तीन टाइप्स है। So depending upon the way of cooling of the air, depending upon the how the air is cooled, that may cause the precipitation. So that precipitation is in three different types. In these three forms, it may be cyclonic precipitation, or it may be convective precipitation, and third one is orographic precipitation. These are the three types of precipitation. The first type is cyclonic precipitation. Cyclonic precipitation that may cause by the lifting of an air mass due to the pressure difference. If there any pressure difference in the atmospheric air, that air mass is lifted up. So due to which what happens? Cyclonic precipitation that may occur. So like I mean, cyclonic precipitation. Cyclones may weather. ज्याला आपण म्हणतो cyclones, cyclone, the precipitation that may cause due to the cyclone, त्याला काय म्हणायचं cyclonic precipitation. When cyclones are created, cyclonic precipitation is created. If low pressure occurs in an area, air will flow horizontally from the surrounding area. From the area having low pressure to the to that may cause to lift. The low pressure occurs in an area, air will flow horizontally from the surrounding area to the that low pressure area. That may cause the air in the low pressure area to lift up. ज्यावेळेस वारा एका म्हणजे ज्या ठिकाणी प्रेशर जास्त आहे आणि ज्या काही ठिकाणी प्रेशर एका एरियामध्ये प्रेशर काय कसं आहे कमी आहे. One area is having low pressure area and another is having high pressure area. The air will flow from that surrounding area towards the low pressure area in a horizontal direction. During this transmission of the air from surrounding area to low pressure area, that may cause to lift up the air mass gets lifted up. That may result in the formation of cyclones. Cyclones are formed. त्यामुळे काय होईल cyclonic precipitation, a precipitation that results due to this transmission of the air from surrounding area to the low pressure area. That may result in the formation of cyclonic precipitation. म्हणून त्याला काय म्हणायचं नॉन फ्रंटल सायक्लोनिक प्रेसिपिटेशन. यामध्ये दोन टाइप्स आहेत सायक्लोनिक प्रेसिपिटेशन मध्ये, फ्रंटल सायक्लोनिक प्रेसिपिटेशन आणि नॉन फ्रंटल सायक्लोनिक प्रेसिपिटेशन. तर फ्रंटल सायक्लोनिक प्रेसिपिटेशन म्हणजे काय? इफ वन एअर मास लिफ्ट्स ओव्हर अनदर एअर मास, when one air mass is lifts up which lifts over the another air mass, that precipitation is called frontal cyclonic precipitation. In non frontal cyclonic precipitation what happens? The air mass is lifts up lifts from surrounding area towards the low pressure area. That may cause the non frontal cyclonic precipitation. So in frontal cyclone precipitation, what happens? The one air mass lifts up over the another air mass. One above the another. In that case, frontal cyclonic precipitation that may occur. If one air mass lifts up or lifts up another air mass. So that precipitation is said to be frontal cyclonic precipitation. And the boundary between these two air masses, the boundary between this warm air mass and cold air mass. So that boundary surface, the boundary between these two air masses is known as frontal surface. Like I mentioned, the frontal surface boundary between two air masses of different temperature and densities. So it's a doni air mass temperature vegvegle ahe, temperature and density vegvegle ahe. Tyamadli ji boundary ahe, contact surface ahe. Boundary surface between these two air masses that may cause cyclonic precipitation. Tyala kay manacha? Frontal surface. That is known as frontal surface or front. So what is cyclone? Cyclone is the large whirling mass of air at the center of which barometric pressure is low. Cyclone cha center la barometric pressure kami ase. Barometric pressure is low at the center of the air mass. So it rotates. If cyclone vadal pahile asel, that air mass gets rotated. The large whirling air mass that is known as cyclone. So that cyclone that will flow horizontally from surrounding area to the low pressure area by which the cyclones are formed. So that may result in the formation of cyclonic precipitation. Manun tyala kay manacha? Cyclonic precipitation. Cyclone manje kay? A large whirling air mass at the center of which barometric pressure is low. That is known as cyclone. Samala, what is cyclonic precipitation? Any difficulty, please ask. Samal nasal tari vichara. Any difficulty in this? Samal laga cyclonic precipitation manje kay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next lecture we'll see another two types, convective precipitation and orographic precipitation. Here we'll stop. Next lecture will continue. Everyone give attendance in chat box. Type the roll number in chat box. Type only roll number. Okay. Give the attendance in chat box. Give the attendance.